his arms around her shoulder, and with a voice that sounded older, he said, "Mom, I got something on my mind. I don't want to bother you, but I sure need to talk to you if you can only spare the time. And Mom, I hope you understand how much I love and need you, and I don't want you to take this the wrong way. But don't you think I'm old enough and big enough and strong enough to play the games that daddies play? My friend Billy Parker's dad came by today to see me, and he wondered if I'd like to go with him and Billy on a hike and maybe camp out overnight the way I've seen them do in picture shows. And there's one thing I'd like to do, and maybe if I ask him to, he'd sit and talk with me man to man. We'd only be gone overnight, and I could find out what it's like to play the games that daddies play." She quickly turned to hide the tears from her son of 7 years. He didn't know she'd read between the lines. He'd never really known his dad, and although he'd never asked, she knew exactly what was on his mind. She searched her mind in desperation. 6 long years of separation dimmed the words she knew she had to say. "I hope you're never big enough or old enough or bold enough to play the games that daddies play. I know you need and want his love, but son, you're the victim of another kind of game that daddies play.